A very good morning to all. Today we are celebrating the 14th convocation of Ganpat University. We are having with us Mr. Krishan Arora, who has completed his B.Tech in Electronic and Communication Engineering from UV Patel College of Engineering, Faculty of Engineering and Technology. What is your future goal now, Krishan?
Actually, I want to become an IAS officer, but there are two types of goals, short-term goal and long-term goal. Firstly, the short-term goal is become a good engineer.
Right.
That is proceeding. But in future, I want to become an IAS officer.
Right. Today we have with us Pankti Thakkar, who has completed Masters in Information Communication from Department of Computer Science. Hello, Pankti.
Hello, sir.
She is also one of the gold medalists. And she is here with us for sharing her experience. Pankti, what did you like the most through your stay at Ganpat University?
So I can say that I loved everything, but most importantly, I love the faculties here. People are extremely helpful and very dedicated, plus they are very knowledgeable. So I think whenever I had any doubts, you know, they are there to explain, plus they are very positive.
Right. So, you like the faculty.
Yes.
Now, if you want to give any message to your juniors, those who are studying over here or going to get admission, what message you want to pass to your juniors?
So, I want to pass a message that never miss an opportunity to win. And life is just not about achieving, it's also about balancing. So, enjoy plus achieve.
Right. Enjoy plus achieve.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Pankti, for a very good message. Here we have with us Pathan Mahera, who has completed her BSc Microbiology from Mehsana Urban Institute of Sciences. Mahera, can you share some of your experiences with Ganpat University, please?
So actually, I want to say that my every day is in a new start, and every day is a new experience. I used to have new experience every day during my lectures, during my lab activities. We have learned a lot we have learned. The best part is participating in each and every activity.
Right.
We have learned a lot, like Shodh, Science Day, everything I can say, but are the very much the teachers, the faculties over here. Actually, when I came here 3 years back, I was not knowing what I'm going to get in return. But the helping nature and the enriching environment here gave me that, yeah, not, I'm not far away from this, and everyone was very helpful.
Right.
Yes.
Here we have with us Ms. Devanshi Patel. She did her Master in Information Technology from Department of Computer Science, Faculty of Computer Applications. Hello, Devanshi.
Hi, sir.
So you are on the day of your convocation and going to receive a very prestigious award, which is a gold medal today. Can you share your best moment, a very remembrance moment, right?
That sir, you want each to. And every moment is the best moment over here.
Okay.
But I can say when I was come 3 years back at the time of convocation of my bachelor degree, at that time I was sitting over in front of the gold medalist, and I was thinking like one day I will also pursue my master degree with the gold medal.
Very
so
nice.
That is my biggest moment. And
today we have with us Ms. Pratha Patel. She did her BSc Biotechnology from Mehsana Urban Institute of Sciences, Faculty of Science. Hello, Pratha.
Hello, sir.
Today you are going to receive your gold medal. This is your graduation ceremony. So, what is your future plan now?
Actually, I am pursuing my Master's in Regulatory Affairs from Northeastern University, Toronto.
Okay.
And will be going there in Jan 2021.
Very nice.
So, in future, I would like to be a researcher if we face such kind of pandemic, like in future. I want to be part of such pandemic, like nowadays we are having new viruses.
Team of a team who is going to provide the solution for that, right?
Yeah, sure.
Right. Today we have with us Ms. Vaishali Patel. She did her MSc Microbiology from Mehsana Urban Institute of Sciences. Hello, Vaishali.
Hello, sir.
Vaishali, can you share your experiences with Ganpat University?
एक्चुअली सर मैं जब यहाँ पे आई थी मतलब एडमिशन लिया था मैंने तब मेरे को थोड़ा डर सा लग रहा था क्योंकि मेरे लिए सब नए थे बट जब यहाँ पे आई दो साल मैंने मतलब स्टडी की सारे इवेंट हो रहे थे यहाँ पे मतलब साइंस फेयर है फिर जीएसई है सब में पार्टिसिपेट किया तो मेरे को एक नया मतलब सीखने को मिला है कि कैसे सब में पार्टिसिपेट करते कुछ नया सीखने को मिला है एक कॉन्फिडेंस एक्चुअली मेरे में बहुत अच्छा आया है और मतलब और फैकल्टीज भी बहुत अच्छी है तो उनसे भी मेरे को बहुत अच्छे से नॉलेज मतलब मिला
है Ms. Krishna Shekhawat. She completed her Master of Science in Organic Chemistry from Mehsana Urban Institute of Sciences, Faculty of Sciences. Hello, Krishna.
Hello, sir.
Today on this very auspicious day when you are going to receive your gold medal, can you share a few of your experiences with Ganpat University?
Okay, sir. So initially, when I started, you know, pursuing here, my education. So I was completely a shy girl. I still remember I was a person who used to sit in middle and I never used to speak anything. But after coming here, I got so much opportunities basically where I got the opportunity to explore myself, you know, to participate, to present myself at such stages like Shodh. Right. Then we get Gujarat Science Congress and you know, science stream mein bahut saari
science aisi, fest and all other
yeah exactly right. So that really boosted my confidence level. So I've completed my bachelor's in science also from here only and my master's also. Okay. So for my friends and all it is completely a surprise that you know such girl she's always shy and now she's getting you know the stage and I'm getting the gold medal tag.
Right. Today so, we have with us Miss Maitri Dave. Hello Maitri.
Hello, sir.
She has completed her M.Tech in Biomedical Engineering from UV Patel College of Engineering, Faculty of Engineering and Technology. Maitri, today you are going to receive your gold medal for your M.Tech course. So, what does it take to become a gold medalist?
I am extremely grateful to the Ganpat University for the best honor to the student life and I have always strived for excellent skills in my discipline
right.
And at Ganpat University, I have received it.
Right.
Gune is a culture of enablers and I got maximum benefit out of it.
Right. Today we have with us Shubhayu Mitra. Hello Shubhayu. He has completed his M.Pharm in Pharmacology from SK Patel College of Pharmaceutical Education and Research, Faculty of Pharmacy. Shubhayu, today you are going to get your gold medal after completing your M.Pharm course. So, since it's a big achievement for anyone in his or her life, what message you want to pass to your junior with this achievement?
First of all, I would tell all the juniors to just focus on your particular subject. It's very important. You should love and devote yourself to the particular subject you study. You should be always interested. And the subject you are always interested in, you must know the things outside the textbook. You don't have to just know about things which are given in the textbook. And you have to just plan your future first.
Right.
There is a broad subject, length of subjects in B.Pharm. So you have to sort out which subject you are most interested in. And later on, you should go up to complete that particular subject.
As we are celebrating our 14th convocation at Ganpat University, today we are fortunately have with us Dr. Ajay Gupta sir, Director of Research and Development, Ganpat University. Sir, I would like to ask you to share your vision as a Director of Research and Development for Ganpat University in the research and development area, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, actually at present, there are lot of research is happening at Ganpat University, especially in science departments and the faculty of pharmacy. But we need to strengthen the research and development activities at the university. For that, we are developing several projects. We have conceptualized various projects. in different areas, in different faculties. So for each faculties, we are identifying 3 to 4 core areas, which will be the thrust areas for the next 2 to 3 decades, where we will be carrying out the research activities. So for these research activities, they will be mainly focused on the society. These projects will be focused on for the benefit of the society, benefit for the industry and the mankind. So we are taking up this activity, and for that we will be collaborating with the national institutes and foreign institutes and industry. For that we are also asking for the funding to the different government organizations. So we are recruiting the people and skilled manpower for different R&D projects. So our idea is to develop the trained manpower to provide which is ready and which can be used by the industry and the different academic institutions. We are focusing on to file the patents for these projects and publish the high impact publications. Yeah.
Right. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Now the student who are willing to aspire their research in any of the domain after completing their post graduation or even in their master they want to aspire the research. Sir, what is your advice to those students, those who want to contribute in research in their respective domain, sir?
See, the research is not a part-time job.
Right.
So it has to be a dedicated, you know, you need to dedicate your full time to the research. So whatever you do, you have to be innovative. You have to continuously update your knowledge. You have to read. So keep reading and interact with the experts in your area and follow the advice. So in that way, you have to with dedication, hard work and proper guidance.
We are honored to have with us Dr. Shaurabhi Chaturvedi ma'am, Dean, Faculty of Management Studies.
I think in the class I have talked a lot to them. I would not like to preach anything right now because it has always been done in the class. So on a lighter note, I would just like to bless them and wish them best of wishes. And I say that please stay connected because, you know, it brings happiness to us. Being teachers, it is always a pleasure and we feel pride when we see our students, you know, reaching heights, heading some organizations or doing some really good job for the society. So my blessings are with them and today I would like to just wish them best of their wishes and may they achieve whatever they want to do in their future.
We are privileged to have with us Shri Jayanti Bhai Patel, member of Board of Governors, Ganpat University. Good afternoon, sir. Ganpat University આજનો 14મો પદવીદાન સમારંભ યોજી રહ્યો છે અને ટોટલ 2900 થી પણ વધારે સ્ટુડન્ટ ને ડિગ્રી મળવાની છે અને તમે ગણપત યુનિવર્સિટી સાથે લાંબા સમયથી એસોસિએટેડ રહ્યા છો તો અમારા સ્ટુડન્ટ્સને એમના પેરેન્ટ્સને ગણપત યુનિવર્સિટીનું ફ્યુચર વિઝન શું છે, ભવિષ્યમાં કેવી રીતે આગળ વધશે એના માટે બે શબ્દો
જણાવો. સૌપ્રથમ તો હું આજે 14મા વાર્ષિક પદવીદાન સમારંભમાં 2900 વિદ્યાર્થીઓ જ્યારે સામેલ થઈ રહ્યા છે તો તમામે તમામ વિદ્યાર્થીઓને તેમજ તેમના માતા પિતાને પણ હું આ પ્રસંગે ખૂબ ખૂબ હૃદયપૂર્વક અભિનંદન પાઠવું છું. એ તમામે તમામ વિદ્યાર્થીઓ આ યુનિવર્સિટીમાંથી જ્યારે એમની પદવી લઈને જ્યાં પણ જશે ત્યાં હર હંમેશા ગણપત યુનિવર્સિટીને યાદ કરતા રહેશે. વિદ્યાર્થીઓ હર હંમેશા એમના માતા પિતાને તેમજ ગણપત યુનિવર્સિટીને કાયમ માટે યાદ કરે એ જ અભ્યર્થના. તમામે તમામ વિદ્યાર્થીઓને મારા તરફથી ખૂબ ખૂબ અભિનંદન અને એમના જીવનમાં ખૂબ પ્રગતિ કરે એવી પરમગુરુ પરમાત્માની મારી પ્રાર્થના છે.
વી આર ઓનર્ડ ટુ હેવ વિથ અસ ડોક્ટર અમિત પરીખ સર, ડીન ફેકલ્ટી ઓફ સાયન્સ એન્ડ પ્રિન્સિપલ મહેસાણા અર્બન ઇન્સ્ટિટ્યૂટ ઓફ સાયન્સ ઓન ધીસ ગ્રેજ્યુએટિંગ બેચ ઓફ 2020. પ્લીઝ શેર યોર પીસ ઓફ એડવાઇસ ઓર બ્લેસિંગ્સ ટુ અવર બેચ.
યા, આઈ વુડ લાઈક ટુ કન્વે ધેટ લર્નિંગ નેવર એન્ડ્સ, કીપ ઓન લર્નિંગ. and try to achieve highest standards in your field. And I would like to say that your real journey begins from here.
Right.
So cherish a vision in your mind and continuously work for it. Because the vision that you glorify in your mind, the ideal that you pursue in your heart, that exactly person you will become.
Right.
So finally, I would like to convey that our students should not only be the good professionals, but also the responsible person and worthy citizens of India.
We are privileged to have with us Dr. Kiran Amin sir, Executive Dean, Faculty of Engineering and Technology, Ganpat University. So would you like to tell us any future goals of your engineering and technology?
In the future, let me tell you that during this past 1 year, our students, they have done excellent work. And with that particular, the government of Gujarat has offered prize money of 5 lakh rupees, where the students, they have designed a robot, that is a musical playing robot. The government has appreciated. Honorable Chief Minister also recognized that particular work of our students. Second thing, the AICT has also recognized us, and they have provided 10 lakh rupees fund. Nice. To develop our laboratories. Even during a pandemic situation, we understand that the pandemic, that was a critical for every side. So our students, they voluntarily supported nearby villages, and they have also, the mechatronic students, they have designed robots and automated hand sanitizer machines also. And it was recognized by the AICT, and we received a third rank based on their particular work. And they had given us Utkrishta Sansthan Vishwakarma Award across all the engineering colleges of the country. So such kind of the students, they are doing such efforts. In the future plan, we are planning to establish more center of excellence, like in a renewable energy, we would like to establish. In marine also, we would like to set up some deep diving courses. Right now, we have launched one program that is a BSc Nautical Science this year. And we have received a good response. The second thing is, in other domain also, we are planning to establish centers like automated vehicles, where we are also planning to establish also center of excellence in that particular area.
We are honored to have with us Dr. R.D. Vanjara, sir, Dean, UG Program, Faculty of Engineering and Technology. So today we are celebrating 14th convocation of Ganpat University. On this day, I would like to ask you that now Ganpat University also has international students on board. So what are the services and support system is there for those international students?
So when we have decided to have the international students on the campus, actually we have think of some set of services which are fixed, like about their study, about their culture, about their extra activities. There are some students who probably coming from a country where you know, their communication skill is not good, so we have started extra training for them. But since March, because of this pandemic, you know, there are some events happened. Like, for example, some students were not able to move to their home for a couple of months. Even some students got, you know, sick on the campus, and their parents are far away from our campus. So if you, you know, accumulate all this experience, I think we are in a position to build an excellent ecosystem, where even the students is getting sick, even they are not able to move to their home for, let's say, 6 months or 8 months. I think we have, you know, channelized everything very well. They are happy on the campus. In fact, and the most important is they are very safe, actually, right? So I will tell you, probably there were around 35 students who were here since March to probably September, and they were doing a lot of study, a lot of enjoyment on the campus, and at the same time we have ensured that their health remains safe. So I think we have a well-established ecosystem to accommodate all the needs of the international students, as far as the academic is concerned, as far as the culture is concerned, as far as their health and hygiene is concerned.
Good afternoon, everyone. we have with us Dr. Chinmay Bakshi. He has completed PhD in management. Congratulations for your achievement.
Thank you very
much. Thank you. Sir, would you like to explain how Ganpat University has supported you in your doctorate journey?
Yes, definitely. The system is very good in terms of support, in terms of academic rigor, in terms of understanding what research is all about, in terms of roping more resources, experts, and the administrative support and the guide. The most important thing that I understand is the way they have explained the importance of the study, importance of the subject, the theoretical building process, and the administrative stuff all together is very good ecosystem that we have it here. And they push me as a candidate to reach to next level every now and then. And that helps me to understand my own potential. Every stage, every 6 months, there is an RDC that helps me how I can fine-tune my subject, fine-tune my study, and come with a better output.
Hello everyone. We have Vacheta Urvish Rajeshbhai with us. He has got gold medal in MSc IT IMS. First of all, congratulations for your gold medal. And tell me, what is your experience in Ganpat University throughout your journey?
Experience is very good and lively. Campus life is also very fun and very friendly. And I like the most is professional teacher supports. They have supported me, guided me, motivated in my low time. And pretty much they have provided everything I wanted.
That's great.
India, one of the fastest growing economies in the world. Gujarat, one of the most prosperous and industrialized states in India. Ganpat University, the most student-friendly and industry-linked higher education provider in Gujarat. When you come far away from your home for higher education, you come with a bunch of dreams, lot of excitement, and also a little anxiety of being away from home. But when you arrive at Ganpat University, you will feel the vibes of entering into the world of openness, enormous possibilities, and the feeling of being at home. Our greenest, cleanest, and 24/7 secured campus is spread across 300 acres with modern learning infrastructure, comfortable student housing with a dedicated block for international students, delicious non-vegetarian, vegetarian and staple food. The Vikram Neel Sports Academy has full green field football and cricket ground, Olympic size swimming pool, fully equipped gymnasium and many other sports facilities. Our academic structure emphasizes on a lot of hands-on training and making learning fun. When you learn at our centers of excellence, you're actually equipping yourself with the skills that industry will require when you graduate. Our commitment towards creating limitless opportunities to global learners is demonstrated by the kind of industry-relevant courses we design and offer in our centers of excellence in association with Suzuki Motors for automobile, Bosch Rexroth for automation technologies, Micro Focus for DevOps, machine learning and artificial intelligence, IBM for cloud computing and big data, EC Council for cybersecurity, NASCOM for future skills, National Stock Exchange for capital markets, Safe Educate for logistics and supply chain, and Shalby Hospitals for healthcare, to name a few. We offer diploma, undergraduate and postgraduate programs in engineering, business and management, entrepreneurship, computer applications, pharmacy, pure sciences, maritime studies, nautical science, food technology, architecture, design, social science, social work, commerce and law. are collaborative award programs in association with Victoria University, Australia and Lincoln University, USA, makes global education truly accessible and affordable. This is the reason why every year more than 5,000 students opt to study with Ganpat University and to be a part of the League of Future Leaders.
I was a little anxious about the atmosphere and culture as it was going to be far, far different. But when I came here, the warmth, support, student friendly made me much more comfortable. And also, when it comes to Ganpat University, definitely tops the list. It's my second home now.
The great part about Ganpat University is the excellent student system, because of which I'm able to concentrate on my learning while everything else is taken care of by my university. I believe no university can provide such an ultra-modern facilities and high-quality education at such an affordable price.
It is not just about to learning, but the way it is being learned. My teachers here have made it easier for me to learn, even though I come from a different culture.
Besides other facilities, I like Incubation Center the most. I spend most of the time around this vibrant space as I wish to start my own enterprise after returning back to my country. The Ganpat University has everything to offer me to convert my dreams into reality.
One thing that excites me the most is the surroundings here. It is extremely affluent to learn and explore new things. It gives me enough inspiration and confidence to pursue my dreams.
As far as my career is concerned, I have no doubts about it.
Once I got into Ganpat University,
I'm sure that the practical training I have been receiving here
will be the key to my successful career ahead.
When we asked our students on how do they feel about values they attained while studying at Ganpat University, here is what they expressed.
We are not trained just to be competent, yet insensitive. If so, it will be no less than being a robot.
Knowledge is all a waste if it is not applied in the right direction and at the right time.
The three main qualities of a real human being are love, compassion, and respect.
It is often said that leaders are never born, they are created. However, responsible leaders are the ones who are molded.
To be responsible doesn't only mean to take responsibilities, but it is a core value that all human beings must possess.
A true professional is always known by his skills and ethical practice in his core field.
Fortunately, I studied at Ganpat University, which made me to have compassion for others. And let me tell you, it is the most satisfying way to live with compassion. And it's all because of Ganpat University.
Studying at Ganpat University has not only provided me the knowledge of my subject, but it has also shown me the right direction to use it for the betterment of society.
Being respectful and giving respect are something that makes you stand apart from others in your work culture. These profound qualities are inserted in me by Ganpat University.
The Ganpat University has not only identified the leadership qualities in me, but it has molded me to carry a responsible leadership to serve the society and the nation.
Here at Ganpat University, I become not only a responsible citizen, but also a mature human being.
These core values of ethics and integrity that I imbibed from Ganpat University has paved my way to be a successful and ethical professional.
How exciting it is to be a Gunwan! It's a feeling that cannot be described in words.
Being a Guni, I am not only knowledgeable, but resourceful and responsible too.
I'm so thankful to Ganpat University for not only making me a Gyani, but also a Guni.
Ganpat University has made me Guni in a true sense.
I respect my gurus of the university to make me a Guni person.
I'm blessed to be a Guni professional.
Good morning. A warm welcome to all dignitaries, faculty members, students, their family members and friends from media to the 14th convocation of Ganpat University. Ganpat University's 14th convocation is graced with august presence of the chief guest, Dr. Soraya M. Kohli, the president of California State Polytechnic University, Pomona, USA, president and patron-in-chief of Ganpat University, Dr. Ganpatai Patel, pro-chancellor and director general, Ganpat University, Dr. Mahendra Sharma, honorable members of Board of Governors, Academic Council, members of Trust, and industry partners. We will soon see the procession on screen. The procession will soon begin. The procession has just begun. Chancellor and Director General, Ganpat University, Dr. Mahendra Sharma, Pro Vice Chancellor, Dr. R. P. Patel, Pro Vice Chancellor and Executive Registrar, Dr. Amit Patel, respected members of Board of Governors and Academic Council. We can also see the Executive Deans, Deans, Principals, Heads, Faculty Members, PhD Awardees, Gold Medalists, and the candidates of Passing Out Batch 2020 have also joined the procession. Privileged to witness the convocation procession led by Pro-Chancellor and Director General, Ganpat University, Dr. Mahendra Sharma, Pro-Vice Chancellor, Dr. R.P. Patel, Pro-Vice Chancellor and Executive Registrar, Dr. Amit Patel, respected members of Board of Governors and Academic Council. We can also see the Executive Deans, Deans, Principals, Heads, Faculty Members, PhD Awardees, Gold Medalist and the candidates of Passing Out Batch 2020.
University, having gold medalist and PhD awardees, is entering the premises. The procession is about to enter to the pandal.
Welcome to everyone on 14th Convocation Celebration. The Convocation Procession of Ganpat University, having gold medalists and PhD awardees, is entering the premises. The faculty members and parents are requested to give a huge round of applause when procession enters the premises. In the procession, we have august presence of Pro-Chancellor and Director General Ganpat University, Dr. Mahendra Sharma, Pro-Vice-Chancellor, Dr. R.K. Patel, Pro-Vice-Chancellor and Executive Registrar Dr. Amit Patel, respected members of Board of Governors and Academic Council members.
The procession is entering into the pandal. I request a huge round of applause from parents and students. The procession is entering into the pandal. A huge round of applause from parents, students and faculty members who are present in the convocation. The procession is entering the pandal. Welcome the procession with a huge round of applause.
The convocation procession of Ganpat University, having gold medalists and PhD awardees, is entering the premises. I request all of you present over here to give a huge round of applause.
Welcome the procession with a huge round of applause.
Ganpat University, widely acclaimed as a socially responsible university and known for its strong industry-linked higher education programs, is celebrating its 14th convocation ceremony to celebrate the success and accomplishment of the graduating class of 2020. The university is established with a noble mission of social upliftment through education. Ganpat University has adopted, included, and executed the safety and precautionary measures in all university operations right from the beginning of the global pandemic. When the world is transitioning into a new normal, Ganpat University has taken the initiative in today's time to offer the same joy, excitement and sense of accomplishment to the students while they are officially conferred their degrees and diplomas. As a precautionary measure to ensure the safety of the students and the staff, the 14th convocation was divided and extended to a full-length convocation week, and every day the students from specific academic disciplines were invited to participate and celebrate this important moment of their life.
Even when students were invited to campus for the day, university has taken utmost precautions to ensure contact-free operations throughout the convocation. A unique number pattern is developed to guide the students. Students are assigned a specific number at the time of registration. Students receive the convocation robe of the same number. The position in procession and sitting in the convocation venue are also marked with the same number. The degree files are also assigned with the same number, and they were asked to stand on the position of the same number at the time of group photograph. As a part of safety and precautionary measures, all students are provided masks, gloves, and the sitting arrangement were also made following the social distancing norms.
The dais of 14th convocation is a convergence of the energy and inspiration with the gracious presence of the chief guest, Dr. Suraya M. Kole, the president of California State Polytechnic University, Pomona, USA, who has joined with us online. The president and patron in chief of Ganpat University, Dr. Ganpat I. Patel, who has also joined us with us online. The pro-chancellor and director general of Ganpat University, Dr. Mahendra Sharma, members of the board of governors from USA and India, and academic council of Ganpat University from India and USA. The university is among the few universities to have successfully implemented an industry-oriented and industry-linked higher education model with active collaborations with industries to empower GUNI students to achieve greater success and enhanced employability through exposure to hands-on learning. The university offers diplomas, undergraduate, postgraduate, and research programs under the academic faculties of engineering and technology, pharmacy, management, computer applications, sciences, architecture design and planning, maritime studies, social science, and humanities.
Today, in the 14th convocation, 2,909 students are graduating and will be awarded degrees and diplomas in various disciplines, out of which 75 brilliant students from different disciplines will receive the gold medal, and 9 research scholars will receive the degree for Doctor of Philosophy. We humbly request the President of Ganpat University, Dr. Ganpatai Patel, to declare the convocation open.
I declare the convocation open.
At the outset, I request the gathering to stand up for the Ganpat University song.
Now
Thank you all. Kindly take your seats.
We are honored by the presence of the Pro-Chancellor and Director General of Ganpat University, Dr. Mahendra Sharma, with us. Besides being an acclaimed and eminent educationist, Dr. Sharma has been a profound pillar of Ganpat University since inception. Under Dr. Sharma's active and visionary guidance, Ganpat University has added many laurels and achieved significant milestones to its prestige. The university has signed several MOUs with international universities and multinational companies and established various centers for excellence to strengthen its commitments of offering industry-integrated employability enhancement program. Dr. Sharma's monumental efforts have transformed the university into a forward-thinking university with global recognition. I now request the Pro-Chancellor and Director General of Ganpat University, Dr. Mahendra Sharma, to deliver the welcome address.
Good morning to one and all who are present here for the 14th convocation ceremony. Honorable President of California State University, Pomona, USA, and chief guest of the ceremony, Professor Soraya M. Kole, respected Honorable President and Patron-in-Chief of Ganpat University, our beloved Dada, Shri Ganpat Bhai Patel, Honorable Members of the Board of Governors, Members of Academic Councils, Honorable Respected Trustees, Invited Guests, Dignitaries, Pro Vice Chancellors, Executive Deans of various faculties of Ganpat University, Principals, Directors, Chairpersons, faculty and members of staff of various constituent institutions of the university, members of the organizing committee of 14th convocation, you deserve a special recognition and thanks for pain, risk and effort you have taken for a touch-free and high safety convocation during the ongoing pandemic and helping us live up Dada's vision of students first. Dr. Morvi Pandya has scripted a special convocation song with the support of Dr. Rajan Purohit and Dr. Amit Patel, which is a special feature for this convocation, and I would like to thank the whole team who made it possible. I would request, please play the title song with the permission of the Honorable President. Dada, with your permission, we are playing the 14th convocation song, It's Glimpses. Please play. Goonie, goonie. this special song was crafted because we could not celebrate on the scale we used to celebrate, but we want it to become memorable. So we created this song especially for our students. And thank you, Dada, for your support. Upon this auspicious day and a very proud moment for the university, I am pleased and privileged to extend a warm welcome to one and all who have joined us to celebrate 14th convocation of Ganpat University, celebrated first time virtually. It is indeed gladdening to be among the aura of eminent personalities on and across the dais and screen. Under the prevailing pandemic circumstances of COVID-19, the University Board of Governors, under the leadership of Honorable Chairman Shri Ganpat Bhai Patel, has decided to complete the statutory requirement of conferment of degrees to outgoing batch of worthy students through virtual mode. Convocation is an important day for the university. The talented and bright students who have been carefully groomed for their career and life are ready to set out for their respective future journey. It gives me immense pride to see them today to receive their hard-earned degrees from the benevolent hands of the invited esteemed guests in the presence of Board of Governors, Academic Council, and parents. In particular, we are gratified by the inspiring presence of Professor Cole, President of California State University, Pomona, USA. In more than many ways, Professor Cole is an inspiration for youths, in particular women, through thoughts, actions, and deeds. Professor Cole is the first woman president of the California State University, Pomona. She shares a similar vision for Cal Poly as our honorable patron-in-chief and president of the university, Shri Ganpat Bhai Patel, for our university, that is establishing a model university that inspires creativity, discovery, innovation, embraces local and global challenges, and transforms lives. Friends, the year gone by has been challenging, transformational, as well as memorable for the university. The university lived up to its reputation of being a socially responsible university, brewing out of its foundational value given by respected Dada and the honorable trustees in addressing the challenges of COVID-19. Firstly, the university was pioneer in the state in successfully migrating its learning and teaching to online mode in March 2020 before the lockdown was announced. Addressing the challenges and with minimal pain, using best technology solution and harnessing the prowess of its teaching and support staff, conducted virtual classes, virtual lectures, virtual labs, virtual examination, virtual conferences, webinars, and virtual administration successfully. 11,000 plus students completed the studies with ease, and a strong mentorship process ensured proper handholding. Secondly, the university took upon a mission not only ensuring that its ecosystem comprising of students, staff, support service providers remain corona-free, we undertook strong initiatives to support government in keeping villages in 5-kilometer radius corona-free. The university converted one of its hostels into COVID care facility since the start of pandemic and is still operational, serving patients recovering from infection. The university distributed more than 100,000 masks, homeopathic and Ayurvedic drugs prescribed by Ayush Ministry, along with immunity-boosting khakras developed by Pharmacy and Food Technology Department to 25,000-plus families in neighborhood. The university regularly sanitized all public places in neighborhood villages. The university also recognized corona warriors like health workers, media persons, and security forces. The Robotics Club of students developed a robot nurse for hospitals to minimize interface of health workers with patients to decrease the infection chances. Apart from contribution of staff's salary and a matching fund by Dada to Chief Minister Fund, currently the university is giving specially developed kits for COVID-19 patients along with oxygen support services at home. Friends, during the year, we welcomed the honorable members of the newly constituted Board of Governors, Academic Council, and Finance Committee of the university. Under the vision and leadership of Honorable President and Chairman of the Board, Shri Ganpat Bhai Patel, we feel privileged and take pride in the new board. We welcomed the new board consisting of Advocate Prakash Jani, Shri Govind Bhai Patel, Shri Anand Bhai Patel, श्री प्रतुल श्रॉफ, डॉक्टर गिरिबाला पटेल, मिसेस रीटा पटेल USA, मिस्टर डैनियल मॉन्टप्लेजर USA, श्री जयंती भाई पटेल, श्री रशेश पटेल USA एंड एक्स ऑफिशियो मेंबर्स. ड्यूरिंग नवंबर 2020 अवर बिलवेड दादा ऑनरेबल प्रेसिडेंट एंड पेट्रन इन चीफ ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटी वॉज नॉमिनेटेड फॉर द ऑनररी डॉक्टरेट बाय हिज अल्मा मैटर कैलिफोर्निया स्टेट यूनिवर्सिटी पमोना फॉर हिज रिमार्केबल कंट्रीब्यूशन टू लर्निंग टू कैल पॉली पमोना एंड टू ऑनगोइंग फिलेंथ्रॉपिक एफर्ट्स दैट हैव सो ग्रेटली बेनिफिटेड नॉट ओनली कैल पॉली पमोना हर कम्युनिटी बट ऑल्सो थाउजेंड्स ऑफ यंग पीपल इन इंडिया एंड ग्लोबली. इट इज़ नो हिडन फैक्ट दैट इज सेल्फलेस डोनेशन ऑफ रुपीज 85 crore दैट इज $11.55 million दादा इज कमिटेड टू मेक इट 101 crore rupees बाई ईयर एंड दैट इज $13.72 million. Probably this is the single largest donation in education by an individual in the country, has created an institution which has educated and empowered 54,000 plus students till date and shall remain perennial source of social transformation through education for centuries. In the writings of Khalil Gibran, the Lebanese-American philosopher on giving, asked the rich man to God, "Speak to us of giving." And the God answered, "You give but little when you give of your possessions. It is when you give yourself that you truly give." Dada, who in his own words feel that he is only the instrument of giving chosen by God, has given his 100% to the mission of this great institution, Ganpat University. Dada says that until his last breath of his life, he wants to be an educationalist, not limited to India or USA. He and Manju Dadi see a great potential in coming generation and wants to harvest it with care. It is visible in the transformation of the university under his active guidance as president of the university. Dada brought strong values and they have articulated who we are. Under his guidance, the renewed identity of Ganpat University is Guni, and our focus is students first, character must. In a world where the role of higher education is continuously evolving, Ganpat University has taken on the challenge to adopt and grow. It is worthwhile to mention that under his guidance and dedicated efforts of the staff, the university saw tremendous preference among students, and in spite of the prevailing pandemic challenges, the university enjoyed preference in admissions and have successfully introduced several industry-linked and employment-oriented courses. The preference is significant in terms of quality of students, diversity of students, and increasing preference among girls for the university. The university this year has successfully entered into the new domains of nautical science, business analytics, startup and entrepreneurship management, and pharmaceutical analytics, and enhanced its entry into the domain initiated last year into food technology, petrochemical engineering, cybersecurity, artificial intelligence, robotics and automation, logistics and supply chain management, biomedical sciences, and medical lab technology, preparing industry-relevant manpower to meet the needs of the industry and strengthen its growth. The Director General of Shipping has approved Bachelor of Science in Nautical Science to be offered from this year, and the university has successfully initiated. And today, university is the biggest marine education provider in the state of Gujarat, with BTech in Marine Engineering, BSc in Nautical Science, Graduate Marine Engineer course, GP rating, ETO, and STCW courses. The university launched MBA in Business Analytics program with Statistical Analysis System, SAS USA, giving opportunity to students to pursue career in business analytics domain. To enable entrepreneurship culture at the university, keeping in view of growing startup environment globally, and to support Atmanirbhar Bharat and Make in India initiatives, the university has launched MBA Startup and Entrepreneurship program successfully this year. The university is currently incubating startups and is proud of four of its startups, Kachwa.com, Moor.com, PDV, and Toy Mahal. I consider it absolutely befitting the occasion to reflect upon the accomplishment of our students, alumni, faculty, and the university throughout the year. Ganpat University and its constituent institutions were bestowed with several recognitions during the year, namely Gujarat State Institutional Ranking Framework, GSIRF, recognized Ganpat University with 4-star overall rating, with 5-star grading in graduation outcome, and 4-star on teaching learning resources and outreach criteria. Outlook Magazine conducted Outlook Eye Care India University Ranking 2020, ranked Ganpat University among top 50 state private university of the country, second year in row. Ganpat University's Sri S.K. Patel College of Pharmaceutical Education and Research was ranked among top 100 pharmacy colleges by National Institute Ranking Framework conducted by Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India. Ganpat University was conferred Excellence in Entrepreneurship Education Award under the national category at recently concluded 17th World Education Summit during November 26, 2020. UV Patel College of Engineering was bestowed with third rank in Utkrish Sansthan Vishwakarma USVA 2020 Award by AICTE for fighting against COVID-19. Ganpat University B.S. Patel Polytechnic was recognized as Social Entrepreneurship Swachhata SES and Rural Engagement Cell Institution by Mahatma Gandhi National Council of Rural Education for sanitization and hygiene, waste management, water management, energy conservation and greenery during and post COVID-19. KVK Krishi Vigyan Kendra is awarded with A rank by National Institute of Labour Economics Research and Development, an autonomous institution under Niti Aayog, Government of India. And this is an exemplary achievement by our KVK in a row. Shrimati Manjulaben Ganpatbhai Patel Sainik School was awarded the Platinum School Award and the Best Motivational School Award and under the IME Education Foundation. Ganpat University's continued commitment to quality, modern and high-tech infrastructure facilities to strengthen education delivery saw certain projects and capital investments being done during the year. Our beloved Dada, Shri Ganpatbhai Patel, has generously donated $4 million USD, around 29.43 crore rupees this year, for the development of Ganpat University during the financial year 2019-20. Shri B.S. Patel, the principal donor of B.S. Patel Polytechnic, has generously donated $100,000 for the development of Ganpat University's B.S. Patel Polytechnic's petrochemical labs and workshops. Ganpat University Microforest was inaugurated on the occasion of 74th Independence Day of India. The university has planted additional 20,000 trees, taking the student tree ratio to 1:5. By achieving Dada's vision, Dada thought that it would be done by 2021, but we have achieved it in 2020 before the pandemic goes. We have also planned to develop a herbal garden with 1,000 plus medicinal herbs in the microforest. University has set up full-fledged, massive open online courses, programs, recording studios in the campus, and soon the university courses which are being offered online shall also be enabled with in-house developed MOOCs in each of the course. Ganpat University is upgrading its healthcare facility on the campus and has appointed full-time resident medical officer and nurses and has procured a cardiac ambulance for medical emergency services, a pharmaceutical store and a medical pathology lab is also being set up. Among the achievements, the student team have continued to bring laurel to the university nationally and globally. I will take note of few of the great achievements amongst hundreds of achievements. Mr. Rishikesh Bagul, Mr. Hiren Gajera, and Mr. Ravi Patadia from Ganpat University Faculty of Engineering and Technology have received prize money of ₹500,000 in robot playing musical instrument category during RoboFest Gujarat 2020. Mr. Darsh Patel, Mr. Shubham Upadhyay, Mr. Deo Patel, Mr. Gopal Jaiswal, Mr. Vidhan Rai, and Ms. Pooja Sinojia from Ganpat University Faculty of Engineering and Technology won Smart India Hackathon 2020 Software Edition with a cash prize of ₹100,000 organized by Government of Goa. Mr. Parth Jain, Mr. Kevin Parikh, and Mr. Nipul Bindal from Ganpat University Faculty of Engineering and Technology designed automated hand sanitizer machine during the pandemic of COVID-19 and has been recognized by Government of Gujarat. The students of Ganpat University Faculty of Engineering and Technology, Mr. Avadh Vanparya, Mr. Vivek Vora, Mr. Paras Vekarya, Mr. Yashrang Parmar, and Mr. Mitesh Vyas have designed a robot nurse and a surveillance drone, and which has been the robot nurse is being put up in hospitals in Rajkot, where they are helping the health workers to minimize the contact with the patients and deliver the medicine and also do temperature and other checkups. Looking at our students of A.M. Patel English Medium, Ms. Meshwa Patel of 9th standard has achieved a gold medal in Karate KMK 2019 and bronze medal in Karate KMK 2019 at state level. And she has also participated in Rangotsav 2018-19 and has been also recognized for Vanya Jeevan Ratna Award, Save the Earth Program. The 18 students of Srimati Manjulaben Ganpatbhai Patel Sainik School are qualified in National Means Cum Merit Scholarship Examinations, and now they are receiving the scholarship amount. Under faculty achievement, one of the important achievement was Dr. Hemal Shah, Principal Ganpat University Institute of Computer Technology and Dean IT, Support Services as Principal Investigator has been awarded for establishment of supercomputer facility for students and academic researchers for conducting high-end in-house advanced computing studies and research work by Gujcost, Government of Gujarat. Dr. Rakesh Vanjara, Dean Undergraduate Program, Faculty of Engineering and Technology, has received a grant of ₹900,000 for modernization and removal of obsolescence rural Modrob Rural from AICT New Delhi to upgrade laboratories of computer department. Dr. P.U. Patel, Dean Faculty of Pharmacy, has received a grant of ₹1,100,000 for conduct of project development, characterization and food application of guar chroma protein concentration under the Research Promotion Council scheme from AICT. Dr. Suraj Shah, Assistant Professor with Ganpat University Center for Management Studies and Research, won the second best prize, Best PhD Thesis Award nationally, and the first prize in Best Research Paper category for his research paper at Prestige Institute of Management and Research, Indore, during January 11-12, 2020. Under the key events, in spite of the challenges and prior to pandemic and during the pandemic, the university has continued to organize more than 100 events, international conferences, seminars, and workshops. Among them noteworthy were International Conference on Computer Science, Communication, and Security in association with Springer. And this conference was conducted virtually and was the first conference, international conference in Gujarat, which was conducted virtually after the lockdown. Ganpat University hosted the Gujarat Science Congress, 34th Gujarat Science Congress, in which 500 participants participated and 350 science projects in 7 different categories were presented. Ganpat University's own Shodh Student Research Convention was held, and there were around 250 ideas in 5 categories of agriculture, basic sciences, engineering and technology, health and allied sciences, nutrition, social science and humanities were presented. Under the several initiatives which was undertaken with the approval of the board under the vision of the Honorable Chairman, Ganpat University has gone for employees group accidental policy covering all the employees. There is a group insurance policy for COVID-19 which has been taken, which has covered all the employees to ensure that they work without any stress of getting infected, and even if there is a support from the university. And there is a scheme for group term life insurance policy looking at the prevailing pandemic situation to support the families, which Dada had intended that we support each and every family. And earlier we had passed a scheme that anybody who was in service passed away, their kids would be educated at the university till they complete their college. Ganpat University continued its Foreign Speakers Distinguished Lecture Series with several top-notch individuals and intellectuals around the world who addressed its distinguished lecture series. The prominent names included Padma Bhushan Professor Jagdish Seth, Dr. Thomas R. Henderson, Professor Parsuraman, the father of services marketing, Dr. Justin Paul, Professor David Bitton, Larson Baker, Dr. Colin Heron, Dr. Warner Kurtz, Dr. Darshan Desai, and there were several top individuals and intellectuals who during the period delivered their intellectual thoughts to the staff and the students. Among the public lecture leadership series, Shri H.K. Patel talked on Jagrut Mehsana, Swasth Mehsana. Shri Y.M. Shukla, Honorable Charity Commissioner, talked on social responsibility of the trust. And under the distinguished lecture series, Dr. Amrinder Pani, Joint Director, AIU, Association of Indian University, Pooja Anand Swarup Swami, BAPS Gandhinagar, Dr. Anil Bharadwaj, Director of Physical Research Laboratory, Pooja Gyanvatsal Swami, Mr. Pavan Bakeri, Mr. Dinesh Yadav. They talked to students on various topics and brought their experience and expertise to the university. Under collaborations, Ganpat University has entered into several leading collaborations during the year. University has signed an agreement with Arvind Envisol Limited for Center for Sustainable Engineering and Management, Logistics Sector Skill Council for BBA and MBA in Logistics and Supply Chain Management, National Research Development Corporation for inculcating research culture in the university, as also for registering the patents. Among several initiatives and collaborations, other noteworthy are with SAS Institute USA for MBA in Business Analytics, Gujarat Livelihood Promotion Company, a joint venture of Government of Gujarat for Deen Dayal Upadhyay Gramin Kalyan Yojana, and the university has been awarded a fund of rupees 8 crores to train 1,000 youths on different skills for the next 3 years. Ganpat University Institute of Architecture has collaboration with Faculty of Architecture, SCAT, Surat, to unlock the opportunities and exposure for our architecture students. The university has added to its team Director R&D, Director Accreditation Rating and Ranking, Chairperson, Executive Education, and many more high-intensity intellectuals during the year. We are taking up futuristic, high-intensity, nation-transforming project under Dada's guidance. Dada shall aptly talk about it during his speech. We are certain that we will continue to build on our strengths in positioning the university for the next phase of growth and transformation. The whole nation is transforming itself into one of the world's most sustainable countries, and Ganpat University, through its people, shall be a key player in our nation's education development. My dear students and parents, you are the very reason we are here today. We congratulate you and believe that our Gunwans will make us proud by thoughts and deeds. I take this opportunity and on my closure note, recite few lines of revered poet Harivansh Rai Bachchan, लहरों से डरकर नौका पार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों की हार नहीं होती, असफलता एक चुनौती है, स्वीकार करो, क्या कमी रह गई, देखो और सुधार करो, जब तक न सफल हो, नींद चैन को त्यागो तुम, संघर्ष का मैदान छोड़कर मत भागो तुम, कुछ किए बिना ही जय जयकार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वाले की कभी हार नहीं होती. वंस अगेन आई एक्सटेंड माई वार्म वेलकम टू वन एंड ऑल. थैंक यू. जय हिंद.
Thank you, sir, for your encouraging welcome address.
We now request the president of Ganpat University, Dr. Ganpat I. Patel, to virtually welcome the chief guest of the convocation, Dr. Soraya M. Kohli, the president of California State Polytechnic University, Pomona, USA.
On behalf of entire Ganpat University family, I heartily welcome you, Dr. Soraya Kohli.
We also feel honored and privileged to welcome all the guests on the dais to accept the book as a token of welcome. Thank you for your motivating presence. Moving forward to the most awaited part of the ceremony, we would request the Honorable President Dr. Ganpat I. Patel to grant the permission to commence the program of conferring the degrees and diplomas in various faculties of Ganpat University.
Let the candidate be presented.
Thank you, President, sir.
Students, kindly pay attention that when the Executive Dean announces the name of your degree, you are requested to stand up at your place to honor the degree. And you have to remain standing until the President may confer the degree and abide you with the oath. I request Executive Dean, Faculty of Engineering and Technology, Dr. Kiran Amin, to please present the candidates.
Candidates for the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy in Engineering and Technology, Master of Technology, Bachelor of Technology and Diploma in Engineering, please rise. Honorable President, sir, I present to you two candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Engineering and Technology. 90 candidates for the degree of Master of Technology in Computer Information Technology, Electrical Engineering in Power Systems, Electronics and Communication in VLSI and Embedded Systems, Civil in Construction Engineering and Management, Transportation Engineering, Structure Engineering, Mechanical Engineering in CAD/CAM, Advanced Manufacturing Systems, Biomedical. 627 candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Technology in Computer Information Technology, Mechanical, Mechatronics, Biomedical, Electronics and Communication, Civil, Electrical, Marine, Computer Science and Engineering in Big Data and Analytics, Cloud-based Applications, Mobile Applications. 108 candidates for the Diploma in Mechanical, Civil, Computer, Automobile, Electrical Engineering, who have been examined and found qualified for the said degrees and diplomas. And I request you to confer the said degrees and diplomas to them. I also request you to confer the said degrees and diplomas to the candidates who are permitted to receive the same in absentia. I request all the candidates to remain standing until the Honorable President confers the degrees and diplomas.
I request Executive Dean, Faculty of Pharmacy and Faculty of Science, Dr. R.K. Patel, sir, to present the candidates.
Candidates for the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy in Pharmacy, Master of Pharmacy, and Bachelor of Pharmacy, please rise. Candidates for the degrees of Master of Philosophy in Science, Master of Science, and Bachelor of Science, Postgraduate Diploma in Medical Laboratory Technology, please rise. Honorable President, sir, I present to you two candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Pharmacy, 15 candidates for the degree of Master of Pharmacy in Pharmaceutics, Quality Assurance, Pharmacology, 96 candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy. I also present to you three candidates for the degree of Master of Philosophy in Science, 341 candidates for the degree of Master of Science in Microbiology, Biotechnology, Mathematics, Physics, Organic Chemistry, Botany, 492 candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Microbiology, Biotechnology, Mathematics, Physics, Chemistry, 36 candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science Honors in Milk Production Management, and 23 candidates for the postgraduate diploma in medical laboratory technology who have been examined and found qualified for the said degrees and diploma, and I request you to confer the said degrees and diploma to them. I also request you to confer the said degrees and diploma to the candidates who are permitted to receive the same in absentia. I request all candidates to remain standing until the Honorable President confers the degrees and diploma.
Thank you, sir. I request Executive Dean, Faculty of Management Studies and Faculty of Social Science and Humanities, Dr. Mahendra Sharma, to present the candidates.
Candidates for the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy in Management Studies, Master of Business Administration, Bachelor of Business Administration, and Postgraduate Diploma in Business Analytics, Enterprise Resource Planning Systems, please rise. Candidates for the degrees of Master of Philosophy in Commerce and English, Master of Social Work, Master of Commerce, and Bachelor of Commerce, please rise. Honorable President, Sir, I present to you four candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Management Studies, 176 candidates for the degrees of Master of Business Administration, Master of Business Administration in Pharmaceuticals, Financial Services, Agribusiness, International Business, Marketing Management, Media and Entertainment Management, 123 candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Business Administration in Financial Services, Marketing Management, Financial Management, Capital Market, 12 candidates for the Postgraduate Diploma in Business Analytics, Enterprise Resource Planning Systems. I also present to you 7 candidates for the degree of Master of Philosophy in Commerce, 2 candidates for the degree of Master of Philosophy in English, 50 candidates for the degrees of Master of Social Work, 14 candidates for the degree of Master of Commerce, 61 candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, who have been examined and found qualified for the said degrees and diplomas, and I request you to confer the said degrees and diplomas to them. I also request you to confer the said degrees and diplomas to the candidates who are permitted to receive the same in absentia. I request all candidates to remain standing until the Honorable President confers the degrees and diplomas.
Thank you, sir. I request Executive Dean, Faculty of Computer Applications, Dr. Satyen Parikh, to present the candidates.
Candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Computer Application, Master of Computer Application, Master of Science in Information Technology, Computer Application and Information Technology, Information Communication Technology, Information Technology in Infrastructure Management Services, Information Technology Cyber Security, Information Technology Mobile Applications, Bachelor of Computer Applications, Bachelor of Science in Information Technology, Computer Application and Information Technology in Infrastructure Management Services. Please rise. Honorable President, Sir, I present to you one candidate for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Computer Application, 103 candidates for the degree of Master of Computer Applications, 126 candidates for the degree of Master of Science in Information Technology, Computer Application and Information Technology, Information Communication Technology, Information Technology in Infrastructure Management Services, Information Technology Cyber Security, Information Technology Mobile Applications, 124 candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Computer Applications, 233 candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Information Technology, Computer Application and Information Technology in Infrastructure Management Services, who have been examined and found qualified for the said degree, and I request you to confer said degree to them. I also request you to confer the said degree to the candidates who are permitted to receive the same in absentia. I request all the candidates to remain standing until Honorable President, Sir, confer the degree. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I request the officiating Executive Dean, Faculty of Architecture, Design and Planning, Architecture Hemant Patel, to present the candidates.
Candidates for the degrees of Bachelor of Architecture, Bachelor of Design, Interior Design, please rise. Honorable President, sir, I present to you 34 candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Architecture, 4 candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Design, Interior Design, who have been examined and found qualified for the said degrees, and I request you to confer the said degrees to them. I also request you to confer the said degrees to the candidates who are permitted to receive the same in absentia. I request all the candidates to remain standing until the Honorable President confers the degree.
Thank you, sir.
By the authority given to me by the Board of Governors as a president of the Ganpat University, I confer on you the said degree and diploma as mentioned by executive deans of the respective faculties, and I charge you that ever in your life, by word and by deed, you will prove yourself worthy of it. I admit the other candidates also for the said degree and diploma in absentia. I mandate you to follow the oath as administered by the Director General.
All the degree awardees are requested to put your right hand forward to take the oath of honesty and integrity. I will have a goal and work hard to achieve that goal. I realize that a small aim is a crime. I will work with integrity and succeed with integrity. I will be a good member of my family, a good member of the society, a good member of the nation, and a good member of the world. I will always try to save or better someone's life without any discrimination of caste, creed, language, religion or state. Wherever I am, a thought will always come to my mind, that is, what can I give? I will always protect and enhance the dignity of every human life without any bias. I will always remember the importance of time. My motto will be, let not my winged days be spent in vain. I will always work for clean planet Earth and clean energy. As a youth of my nation, I will work and work with courage to achieve success in all my tasks and enjoy the success of others. I am as young as my faith and as old as my doubt. Hence, I will light up then the lamp of faith in my heart. My national flag flies in my heart and I will bring glory to my nation. Thank you. Kindly take your seats.
Thank you very much, sir. I request the Executive Registrar, Ganpat University, Dr. Amit Patel, to present the degree register to the President, Ganpat University, Sri Ganpat Bhai Patel, for approval. Please, sir.
Honorable President, sir, I present to you the convocation register for the approval. It contains the name and degree to be awarded to the 2,909 candidates presented by respective executive deans. I request you to approve.
By the authority given to me by the Board of Governors of the President of the Ganpat University, I approve the said degree and diplomas to the candidate mentioned.
Thank you, sir. honorable dignitaries on the dais, respected President Sir, all the BOG members on the dais and virtually who has joined, all the guests of the dais, faculty colleagues, and my dear students. I am pleased to take this opportunity to announce the name of PhD degree awardees. All doctorate candidates are requested to come forward as I call their name and receive the degree from Honorable Pro Chancellor and Director General. I request Honorable Pro Chancellor and Director General Sir to do the honor first. For the degree of PhD in Faculty of Engineering and Technology, Patel Harshad Kumar Chaturbhai, who has done his PhD under the guidance of Dr. D.M. Patel. Second candidate, Prajapati Jayesh Kumar Chelabhai, under the guidance of Dr. K.G. Maradia. For the degree of PhD in Management, Bakshi Chinmay Om Prakash, under the guidance of Dr. Jayesh Patel. For the degree of PhD in Management, Rajdev Paras Kumar Mahesh Bhai, under the guidance of Dr. Hiren Patel. PhD in Management, Bhatt Salil Yogendra, under the guidance of Dr. Amit Patel. Please give all of them a big round of applause. Thank you, sir. The production of new knowledge through the practice of research lies at the heart of the university's mission. Yet, without effective and ongoing dissemination of knowledge, the efforts of researchers and scholars are wasted. Dissemination, that is, publication, is thus a core responsibility of the university. Without creation of new knowledge and developing applications based on this new knowledge, the survival of education institution, industry, and mankind as well is difficult. At Ganpat University, though we are very young university, we have entrusted the quality research and publication as a core agenda. Today, on this occasion, we take this opportunity to release the Research Compendium, a compilation of abstract work of PhD scholar and other researcher in last 1 year. May I request all the dignitaries on the dais to release the Sankshipti, a research compendium. Please. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. We all know that no gold is as precious as the gold medal. On this occasion, I feel proud to announce the name of the gold medalist for their scholastic performance. Awardees are requested to come forward as I call their name and receive the medal from the honorable dignitaries on the dais. May I request Sri Anand Bhai Patel, honorable member of Board of Governor Ganpat University, to come forward and do the honor. For the degree of Master of Technology in Advanced Manufacturing System, Patel Kanubhai Narottam Bhai. For the degree of M.Tech in CAD-CAM, Patel Karthik भगवती भाई। फॉर एमटेक इन कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग हाजरा परिणीता रविंद्रनाथ। फॉर एमटेक इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग चौधरी छाया जयदेव भाई। फॉर एमटेक इन सिविल स्ट्रक्चरल इंजीनियरिंग एज अ स्पेशलाइजेशन गणदेवीकर संतोष। फॉर एमटेक सिविल इन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इंजीनियरिंग पटेल अर्पण नरेश भाई। फॉर एमटेक इन सिविल कंस्ट्रक्शन इंजीनियरिंग एंड मैनेजमेंट द मेडल फॉर स्कोलास्टिक परफॉर्मेंस स्पॉन्सर्ड बाय डॉक्टर पीवी अकलकोटकर फॉर्मर एग्जेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ यूवी पटेल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग सुथार निसर्ग अरविंद भाई। फॉर द एमटेक इन बायोमेडिकल इंजीनियरिंग दवे मैत्रीबेन हर्षवर्धन भाई। Maitri is also a recipient of the medal for overall scholastic performance in the Master of Technology program. The medal is sponsored by late Sri Amrutbhai J. Patel, father of Dr. Amit Patel, Pro Vice Chancellor and Executive Registrar. Thank you, Anand sir. May I now request Sri Govindbhai Patel, Honorable Member of Board of Governor, Ganpat University, to please do the honor. For the degree of Master of Pharmacy in Quality Assurance, Patel Mayank Rajesh Kumar. For the degree of Master of Pharmacy in Pharmaceutics, Patel Priyanka Ben Ashwin Bhai. For the degree of Master of Pharmacy in Pharmacology, Mitra Subhayu Amarnath. Subhayu is also a recipient of overall scholastic performance for the Master of Pharmacy. The medal is sponsored by late Professor P.I. Patel, former Vice Chancellor of Ganpat University. For the degree of Master of Business Administration in Finance, Shah Sweta Ben Vinod Bhai. The medal for scholastic performance is sponsored by Sri Kiran Bhai Patel, Trustee, Ganpat University. For the degree of Master of Business Administration in Agribusiness, Prajapati Jayanti Poonam Bhai. The medal is sponsored by Sri Girish Bhai Desai, Trustee, Ganpat University. For MBA in International Business, there is a two candidate who have secured this medal. I request both the candidate to come one by one. Chudasma Komal Mehul Bhai. For MBA in International Business. For MBA in International Business again, Sukhadia Dhruvi Ben Alpesh Kumar. For MBA in Financial Services, Vora Gautami Jignesh Bhai. For MBA in Pharmaceuticals, Trivedi Harshit Bhargav Bhai. Harshit is also a recipient of overall scholastic performance for the MBA program. The medal is sponsored by Dr. D.V. Patel, Trustee, Ganpat University. Thank you, Govind sir. May I now request Sri Jayantibhai Patel, BOG member of Ganpat University, to do the honor. For the degree of Master of Computer Application, Rudraksh Kumavat Mohanlal. The Medal for Scholastic Performance is sponsored by Sri Natubhai J. Patel, Trustee Ganpat University. For the degree of Master of Science in Computer Application and Information Technology, Patel Heliben Bharatbhai. For Master of Science in Information Technology, Patel Devansi Bindesh Kumar. For MSc in Information Communication Technology, Thakkar Panti Nikunj. For Master of Science in Information Technology Infrastructure Management Services, Vacheta Urvis Rajesh Bhai. Urvis is also a recipient of Overall Scholastic Medal for all the Master in Science program. For Master of Science in Microbiology, Patel Vaishali Ben Kiran Kumar. For MSc in Biotechnology, Priyanka. For MSc in Botany, Bonnie Thakur, she is unable to remain present. Her husband Aditya Desarkar will receive the medal on behalf of her. Thank you, J.S. Patel, sir. I request Dr. Mahendra Sharma, Honorable Pro Chancellor and Director General, to do the honor. For the degree of Master of Science in Mathematics, Patel Binal Ben Pramod Bhai. For the degree of Master of Science in Physics, Suthar Drashti Mahesh Bhai. For the degree of Master of Science in Organic Chemistry, Sekhawat Krishna Rajendra Sikh. Krishna is also a recipient of Medal for Overall Scholastic Performance in Master of Science, sponsored by late Kalyanbhai Mevabhai Raika Parivar, Trustee Ganpat University. For the degree of Master of Social Work in Human Resource Management, Dave Sonalben Rajubhai. For the degree of Bachelor of Technology in Electronics and Communication, Krishnan Arora. For BTech in Mechanical Engineering, Tarun Uperia, the Medal for Scholastic Performance is sponsored by Sri Chandubhai K. Patel, Trustee Ganpat University. For BTech in Mechatronics, Sharma Chirag Vinod, the medal is sponsored by Sri Satnam Singh and Sri Pritam Singh, Trustee Ganpat University. Thank you, sir. I request Dr. R.K. Patel, Pro Vice Chancellor, Ganpat University, to do the honor. For the degree of Bachelor of Technology in Civil Engineering, Patel Dhruv Rajendra Kumar, the Medal for Scholastic Performance sponsored by Sri Prahlad Bhai S. Patel, Ahmedabad, Trustee Ganpat University. For BTech in Electrical Engineering, Patadia Ravi Kumar, Naresh Bhai. Ravi is a winner of the Robo played the guitar contest and he brought the great proud to the university. Thank you, Ravi. For BTech in Marine Engineering, Soda Mahavir Singh, Rajendra Singh. For BTech in Computer Science, in Engineering, Big Data Analytics, Jain Krunal, Keval Chand. For BTech in Computer Science, in Engineering, in Cloud-Based Application, Kasis Gandhi. For BTech in Computer Science and Engineering Mobile Application, Gandhi Rushabh Mukesh. And for BTech in Biomedical Engineering, Suratwala Safina Sahil. Safina is also the recipient of Medal for the Overall Scholastic Performance in the category of Bachelor of Technology, sponsored by late Tulsibai M. Patel, Trustee Ganpat University. Thank you, Dr. R.K. Patel. May I request Dr. Satyen Parikh, Executive Dean, Ganpat University, to come forward and do the honor. For Bachelor of Business Administration, Matwani Sivani Dhiraj Kumar. For BBA in Marketing Management, Jayesh Khuntad. For BBA in Financial Management in Capital Market, Thakkar Harsi Deepak. For BBA in Financial Services, Patel Monique Paresh Kumar. Monique is also a recipient of Overall Scholastic Medal for the Bachelor of Business Administration. For Bachelor of Computer Application, Patel Smith Arun Kumar. For Bachelor of Science in Information Technology, Soni Jeet Rajesh Kumar. For Bachelor of Science in Computer Application and Information Technology, Chaudhary Sivani Sanjeev. Sivani is also a recipient of Overall Scholastic Medal for Bachelor of Science in Information Technology. Thank you, Dr. Parikh. May I request Dr. Rajan Purohit to come forward and do the honor. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Technology, Information Technology Infrastructure Management Services, Prashant Sharma. For Bachelor of Science in Microbiology, Mistri Kinnari Bhupendra Bhai. For this subject, there are two students are getting this medal. I request second one, Pathan Mahira Banu. For the degree of Bachelor of Science, Biotechnology, Patel Pratha Jayesh Kumar. For Bachelor of Science in Chemistry, Patel Nidhi Vinod Kumar. The medal for scholastic performance is sponsored by Shri Kantibai I. Patel, Trustee Ganpat University. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Mathematics, Patel Drashti Dilip Kumar. For the subject of Bachelor of Science in Mathematics, there are two students are getting on the same rank. I request second one, Mansi Sharma, to receive the gold medal from Dr. Rajan Purohit for the subject of mathematics. Thank you, Dr. Purohit. May I request Dr. Kiran Amin, Executive Dean, Faculty of Engineering and Technology, please come forward and do the honor. For the subject of Bachelor of Science in Physics, Shukla Devansi Nikhil Kumar. Devansi is also a recipient of overall scholastic performance medal for Bachelor of Science. Bachelor of Science honors Milk Production Management Chaudhary Sitalben Daljibhai. For the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Patel Pooja Naveen Chandra, the medal for scholastic performance sponsored by Sri Suresh Chandra Mohanlal Mehta, Ahmedabad. For the degree of Bachelor of Architecture, Makwana Raj Kishore Bhai. For the degree of Bachelor of Design in Interior Design, Shukla Devanshi Mukesh Bhai. For the degree of Postgraduate Diploma in Business Analytics, Sa Khyati Manan Bhai. For the degree of Postgraduate Diploma in Medical Laboratory Technology, Dave Bhumiben Naresh Kumar. Thank you, Dr. Amin. May I request Architect Hemant Patel, Officiating Executive Dean of Faculty of Architecture, Design and Planning, to do the honor. For the degree of Diploma Engineering, Civil Engineering, Rathore Mihir Harish Kumar, the Medal for Scholastic Performance sponsored by Sri Mahendra Bhai K. Patel, Chino, California, USA. For Diploma in Automobile Engineering, Patel, Namran Kumar, Alkesh Kumar. For Diploma in Computer Engineering, Kokadia Sagar Dilip Bhai. For Diploma in Mechanical Engineering, Rawal Jaideep Bhai Bharat Bhai. Jaideep is also a recipient of Medal for Overall Scholastic Performance sponsored by Sri Surya Narayan Sharma, father of Dr. Mahendra Sharma, Pro Chancellor and Director General, Ganpat University. Let's give them a big round of applause. Let us celebrate the success of all our students and let's express our sincere gratitude to their parents and professors. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much, sir. As we all know, the college days, the graduating days, are the most precious days of students' life. These days must have created and crafted so many memories in your life. Let us together cherish the memories. It is not possible to invite everyone on the stage. We have three student representatives from overall gold medalist and PhD awardee category with us to share their experiences. Please note, students who are coming for feedback are requested not to touch the mic. I invite Mr. Harshit Trivedi to share his experiences with us.
Dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, faculty members, dignitaries who have joined virtually with us, and I would like to thank a big thanks to the entire team of Ganpat University to make this event and the convocation happen. Because we all know and we are aware about the situation of pandemic, even though Ganpat University has take one step forward and with the following the guidelines of COVID protocols, we are here. First of all, I would like to thank the Ganpat University. I, Harshit Trivedi, completed my MBA in Pharmaceuticals from Ganpat University Center for Management Studies and Research. I would like to congratulate all the awardees and my graduating communities because this is the day where we are waiting and the hard work will pay off. When I was started my MBA, I was thinking that my MBA degree would not only give me the academic excellence, but also it gives me
a skill set which can that can be extended to the industrial demand. During these 2 years, I have learned and I have got the exposures of various international level conferences, national events, workshops, research paper writing, and many more. I would like to thank all the faculties and once again, congratulations to all the graduating communities. Thank you.
Thank you, Harshit. Now I invite Ms. Parinitya Hajra to share her experiences with us.
Respected teachers, parents, all the dear students, and all of you who are present here as well as who are joining us online. First of all, I would like to thank each one of you, and especially I would like to express my gratitude to Ganpat University for giving me this opportunity where I can share the stage and I can share my experience with Ganpat University in front of all of you on this special occasion. As we all know, obviously, this day is very special for all of us because this is the day when we are getting the result of all our hard work, consistent, we are studying consistently throughout our year, and this is the day where we are getting the result. We are getting the award, right? So thanks to all again. And the main thing that I want to highlight about Ganpat University is that Ganpat University is a university that not only educates the student, but Ganpat University evolves the student as a good human being. So I think that is the most important thing that each and all university should do. So this is what plays a very important role in everyone's life. And today, to all my friends who are graduating today, I have a small message for all of you. That as we all know, Ganpat University plays a very important role in social transformation. So all of us, being the student of Ganpat University, let's take a vow that we will also, no matter what we do, where we go, we will always try to make this world a better place to live in. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Parinitha. Now I invite Mr. Salil Bhatt, PhD degree awardee, to share his experiences with us.
To one and all, Ganpat Dada, Sharma sir, Amit sir, all the dignitaries online, offline, present here, all my mentors and faculties, and all my fellows in front of me. Well, they said in earlier times that people who sacrifice food, sleep, family, laughter, and other joys of life are called saints. In recent times, they are called PhD students. I agree with the statement in general, but do not agree when you are a PhD scholar from Ganpat University. I hail basically from corporate and have had very small stint with academia, except for the fact that I saw my wife Megha doing her thesis and PhD degree almost about 15 years ago. So I was very skeptical of going ahead when I got admitted in Ganpat University almost about 4.5 years ago. However, journey has been extremely smooth and hassle-free with Ganpat University in general and Faculty of Management Studies in particular with following traits. Expert guides like Amit sir, expert mentors like Jayesh sir, motivating peers like Dr. Chinmay Bakshi, who is getting the degree today with me, encouraging dean like Sorbi ma'am, obviously super mentor like Sharma sir, smooth but very, very strict policies and processes and extreme adherence to deadlines, I believe Sharma sir and the very passionate team. I was telling one PhD scholar during my viva that the foundation of the university is so strong that the system only will not let you fail. For a person like me who has a lot more to address in terms of allocating time to various activities related to other areas, including my own endeavor, this journey could not have got completed without this campus and the team of leaders continuing the legacy of fantastic vision by Anil Uncle along with our Ganpat Dada, who has been a pivotal role to have made this university which it is today. I've been fortunate to know Ganpat University very closely since the inception, thanks to my very close friend, Mr. Anand Patel, who is one of the boards. The way I've seen the infrastructure, like Maruti line, working ship on the campus, sports complex, eagerness to inculcate innovative practices, continuously offering new courses and motivating students to pursue their dreams is completely unparalleled. I feel fortunate to be part of the university as PhD scholar and look forward to extending my area of expertise to the universities going forward. I and my wife run an experiential science initiative called Sinotech, which is a combination of sci of science, know of knowledge, and tech of technology for school children, where our tagline is exposure leads to exploration and exploration to innovation. I am so happy that Ganpat University since the inception has been following this motto for higher studies. My deepest gratitude to the management, my guides, my mentors, and the whole team for making me stand here today with my dream coming to the reality. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Salil.
We are delighted to have the charismatic presence of the President and Patroning Chief of Ganpat University, Dr. Ganpat I. Patel, with us. Dr. Ganpat I. Patel, to whom we all lovingly call Dada, the grandfather of the family. The magnitude of his dreams and vision has uplifted many families. He is still deeply grounded. Known as Pat Patel in the USA, he is an Indian-American businessman and philanthropist. In 1978, Dr. Ganpat I. Patel, with the help of his wife, founded Cherokee International, a power supply company. Cherokee secured relationships with businesses like IBM, Cisco, Motorola, and Hewlett Packard, and opened manufacturing facilities in the United States, India, Belgium, and Mexico. He retired from his professional career in 2004. He always desired to contribute to his land of birth, and with this dream, he picked up the mission of establishing this huge education ecosystem named as Ganpat University, which has become a blessing to the aspiring learners and a great service to the nation. As a recognition of his noble contribution to the society, on 11th March 2019, the President of India conferred the fourth highest civilian honor, Padma Shri, to Dr. Ganpat I. Patel. Dada has joined us live from the USA despite the time zone difference, which reflects his contagious energy and love for our students. This gesture truly proves that age is just a number for him. Without stealing the moment, let us have the inspirational words from the President and Patroning Chief of Ganpat University, Dr. Ganpat I. Patel.
It gives me a great pleasure to welcome each and every one of you on this extraordinary virtual 14th convocation ceremony of Ganpat University. Someone has rightfully said that odds of life leads us to experiment and to reinvent. In other words, necessity is a mother of invention. Corona pandemic could have stopped us from meeting physically, but life must go on. We must become creative. We must think out of the box. And that is exactly what we are doing today. We are meeting virtually in reality, and definitely it is our victory. I want to congratulate each and every one of the students today on this special occasion. Our chief guest of the day, Dr. Sarvaya Kohli. Thank you, Ms. Kohli. Ms. Kohli, you made my day. I am extremely happy because you are the president of my alma mater, and you are the chief guest of the university today, where I am the president. I am truly blessed. I have a double pleasure today. Thank you, ma'am. Our pro-chancellor, Dr. Sharma, thank you for your dedication. We cannot ask for a better pro-chancellor. Thank you, sir. You have everything that takes to take university to a world class. You're well on your way. Thank you, Dr. Sharma. I want to especially thank our BOG members for their valuable support, their continuous guidance, and under their supervision, university has transformed today. Thank you, BOG members. I also want to thank the members of Special Committee. That committee has done special three projects this year. 3D printing technology lab that we have established, energy innovation lab that we have, and advanced technology center for next generation networks, that is 5G network. This 5G network is, we are part of the 5 IITs, and we are the only non-IIT in that committee. It's run by the central government. I want to specially thank my dear friend Bachar Bhai, Eden Prabhu, and Rashesh Bhai to help us out on these projects. They have spent many, many hours and nights to complete these projects. Our pro vice chancellors, Dr. Amit Bhai, Dr. R.K. Patel, I want to thank you for your dedication, your commitment, and your loyalty to the university. Let me also greet the office bearer of the university, faculty, staff, student, and their parents. I also want to congratulate parents for their children's achievement. This would not have been possible without your unconditional support and love to your child. Thank you. I sincerely hope that we at the Ganpati University have lived up to your expectations. Thank you for putting trust in us, parents. Let us take a moment and thank the founders of this beautiful campus for their dream and devotion and their hard work. They have inspired us by living noble life. They have set a good example for all of us. My dear class of 2020, let me be the first one to congratulate you on your achievement today. You have worked very hard, but you had some help from many, your parents, professors, friends, even the gardeners of this beautiful campus and the peons. They all have played a role in your 4 years of life here. Let us take a moment and thank them sincerely. You will be leaving this campus with a great values. You are a brand ambassador of Ganpati University wherever you go. Goonies have a values: knowledge, integrity, hard work, leadership, honesty, sincerity. Keep these values with you at all time. If you pursue excellence in your life, success will surely follow. People have often asked me, what is the single biggest reason that I was successful? Without hesitation, my answer will be my common sense. Then the next question is, where did you get it from? Believe me, it was my mother, who had no formal education at all. The way she ran the household with absolutely minimum income and many people to support. She was very efficient. She used common sense everywhere. Every moment I could see nothing but a common sense in her while I was growing up. She also taught me to treat others the way you want to be treated. Keep your circle bigger in life. Accommodate as many people as you can in your life. try to be helpful to others, in other words. And the most important thing she taught me was, joy of giving is the best joy you can have. Famous scientist and educationalist Ron Curtis has written a bestseller book. The name of the book is The Five Champion Questions. He has divided life into five major areas. That is our character, the knowledge that we have, our excellence, our values, and our health. And he appeals to everyone to ask these five questions every night before we go to sleep. First question is, what am I thankful for today? In a nutshell, he says, be thankful to everything that happens to you today. Being thankful shows that you are honest, you are honorable, you are appreciative. In short, it shows your character. A person who is thankful is often a good person. His second question is, what did I learn today? You have been at the university for the past 4 years. You have been learning. You are a student. Remain student for the rest of your life. Be curious. Be open to new ideas. And make a learning a lifetime business. His third question is, where did I do a good job today? Whatever you did today, did you give 100% of what you had? Is there a room for improvement? And if there is, work on it. You will never be perfect, but you can get close to it. We call it continuous improvement. His fourth question is, who was I valuable to today? Did I contribute to anyone's life today? Was I helpful to anybody? And how could I do more? How could I be helpful to the society? Now comes the fifth and the last question. How did I take care of myself today? What did I do to improve my own health and my own well-being? He's also talking about not only a physical health, but the mental fitness, your thought process. If you had a good thought, that is just the beginning of a good karma. Sara vicharo manushnu charitra gartar kare cha. These are the great values to live by. I suggest you all practice these thoughts regularly. You will have ups and downs in life. There will be good days and bad days. At any time, keep your life control in your own hand. Let no one run your life. You must control your own destiny. As an individual, we also should live life such a way that we leave this earth in a little better shape than we arrived. We all have been witnessing truly a very ugly and difficult coronavirus. It's very small in size, but truly very big in its power. Coronavirus has brought everything to standstill. Market, business, houses, multiplex, park, gyms, and even academic institutions like ours. They have been forced to close and lock down. Many people are helpless. During this difficult time, education has come to rescue. The doctors, the health workers, police force, scientists, all have been educated about this epidemic. Even at the university, we have been educated. We have become out of box thinker and gone around and helped the society. These people have all learned, have been working tirelessly. They have saved many, many lives in the process. They have also put their own life at risk time to time. We must thank them. Let me now talk about my own life a little bit. I had a great journey from very, very small village, a modest family, growing up not with much. Somehow I ended up in US, got educated, started business in my garage, grew big, made some good money, was successful beyond my imagination, had everything, big house, nice car, nice traveling everywhere. I was riding high, great life. I was blessed. Somewhere along the way, I met my friend Sri Anil Bhai. With all the success that I had, together we decided to build this university called Ganpati University today. And with the help of many, today there is another success also. So I had two successes in my life. The first one was I was successful in a business making money. Second success is what you are seeing today, the Ganpati University. They are both success. The first one was a materialistic. The second one is the success that is called Sarthakta. It is the success that gave me the true meaning of my own life. It also gave me a tremendous joy and satisfaction. I have felt that life was worth living. When I see you, when I see everybody graduating. My dear class of 2020, as I say goodbye to you, I also want to wish you the best. And I want to wish you my second success. Keep visiting your alma mater wherever you can. Again, I want to thank Ms. Kohli for joining us on a special occasion at the Ganpati University. Thank you and good luck to you.
Thank you, President Sir, for the wonderful words of inspiration.
Dr. Soraya M. Kohli is the sixth president of California State Polytechnic University, Pomona, an established educator and administrator with 4 decades of experience in higher education. Dr. Kohli is the first woman to be named president of Cal Poly Pomona. She has ushered in a new era of strategic leadership for establishing a vision for Cal Poly Pomona as a model for an inclusive polytechnic university that inspires creativity, discovery, and innovation, embraces local and global challenges, and transforms life. As a president, Dr. Kohli leads an institution with nearly 30,000 students, 2,700 faculties and staff. Under her leadership, Cal Poly Pomona has continued to grow its legacy as the most diverse polytechnic university in the country and as a national leader in promoting social and economic mobility. Dr. Kohli formally took office in January 2015, and during her tenure, enrollment has grown by 6,000 students and graduation rates of Cal Poly has reached historic levels. In 2019, California Governor Gavin Newsom appointed President Colley to the California Future of Work Commission, which is charged with making recommendations to the governor and legislature regarding the kinds of jobs Californians could have in the decades to come. Dr. Colley is also the member of American Council on Education, Women's Network, the Los Angeles Area of Chamber of Commerce, the Pasadena Bioscience Collaborative, and Los Angeles Coalition for the Economy and Jobs. In 2000, she was recognized as one of the 10 women making a difference by Orange County Metro Magazine. Now we request the chief guest of the convocation, Dr. Soraya M. Colley, the president of California State Polytechnic University, for her message to the graduating class of 2020 of Ganpat University.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for inviting me to participate in the Ganpat University's 14th convocation. I want to recognize and thank President and Patron-in-Chief Patel, Vice Chancellor Sharma, the Board of Governors, the Academic Council, the members of trust, the entire University Administrative Leadership, the Executive Deans and Deans, and the Principals, Chairpersons, and staff. You are engaged in life-changing work that will reverberate for generations to come. And I recognize all the students, families, and friends gathered. I am truly honored to share this occasion with you. Before I share my prepared remarks, I feel compelled to acknowledge the challenges presented by the coronavirus pandemic to communities all over the world. The latest numbers documented at Johns Hopkins University stagger our consciousness. 74 million cases globally, 1.6 million lives lost, and countless more impacted. To all those affected, to all those who've lost loved ones, I offer you my condolences and my hope for better days ahead. Let me again reiterate what an honor it is to be a part of your convocation ceremony. Your achievement that we celebrate today is the next milestone on a journey that began many years ago. Your very first years of schooling, and even before, planted the seeds of today's accomplishments. Countless hours of reading, writing, and studying have led up to this point. And now, you're ready to achieve even greater things, carrying out the rich tradition of this university. I am very grateful to be a part of this moment. Of course, you didn't get here completely on your own. Family, friends, spouses, loved ones, teachers, faculty, mentors, and more all played a role. I want to take just a moment to recognize them and how their support and sacrifice are also being honored today. I, of course, bring you greetings from the students, faculty, and staff at California State Polytechnic University, Pomona, or as we say, Cal Poly Pomona. We're located in the heart of Southern California in the Western United States, where we have been considered a leading American university for more than 80 years. I have the honor of serving as its fifth university president. I am here to tell you that Cal Poly Pomona and Ganpat University are two universities that are very much alike. Both universities focus on the doing of learning. At Cal Poly Pomona, we call it the Polytechnic Advantage. This approach to learning and scholarship distinguishes us from other universities and makes us an epicenter for creativity, discovery, and innovation. We believe that it is not sufficient to only acquire the knowledge associated with the courses. We assert that learning is deepened and students are better prepared when they have the opportunity to apply the learning and demonstrate the knowledge acquired. And we believe that this educational experience provides students with the essential knowledge and skills to succeed and achieve your dreams, regardless of the field you pursue. Cal Poly Pomona and Gunpowder University are also both institutions that believe deeply in the transforming power of education. We believe that people are defined not by their available resources, but by their resourcefulness. The transformative power of education has been the inspiration of your patron-in-chief and president, Mr. Gunpat Patel. I like to think that he gained that knowledge while he was an engineering student at Cal Poly Pomona, but clearly it has been the driving force of his entire life. We are honored to call him among our alumni, and it was a tremendous privilege for Cal Poly Pomona to nominate him for the honorary doctorate he received from the California State University this past year. Graduation is a special moment in your life. It is a turning point. As president at Cal Poly Pomona, I have the opportunity to speak to the graduating class each year. What I share with them are five insights that I've gained over four decades as an educator, and I'd like to share them with you today. The first is to hold high expectations for yourself. Set the bar high and exercise the discipline needed to achieve success. Through your studies at your university, you've already shown you're capable of great things. Now try and do even better. The second is to take action. Don't let a fear of failure inhibit you. Move in the direction of your expectations, and you will succeed. There will always be obstacles. I find it best to always treat challenges as opportunities to improve. The third is be persistent. Know that every failure holds a lesson as well as the seeds of success. As the famed Albert Einstein once said, failure is success in progress. Of course, this is much easier said than done, but never let failure dictate your future. The fourth is maintain options. Look for opportunities to grow and adapt to changes throughout your lifetime. There is always more to learn. Indeed, no characteristic will serve you better than being a lifelong learner. And finally, discover your purpose. Regardless of where you are in life, your talents and gifts are still developing. Be open to new experiences and make choices that align with your curiosity and passion. I'd like to expand on this last point. To me, discovering a purpose requires us to consider what we can achieve beyond ourselves and our immediate interests. Gunpowder University was built around a profound mission: social upliftment through education. This powerful goal requires us to discover what our purpose will be. It also puts your university into the legacy of higher education, reaching back to the earliest such institutions. The world's oldest university is the University of Bologna, located in Italy. But you may find it interesting to know that the world's oldest institution of higher learning didn't start as a school at all. It was an organization dedicated to serving societal needs. Started in 1088, the university is widely accepted as the world's first university. Indeed, the term university as an institution of learning was coined as part of the evolution of the University of Bologna. As one of Europe's centers of intellectual and cultural life during the onset of the High Middle Ages, the university drew students from across the continent to study with prominent scholars. Each of these scholars worked freelance rather than as a joint entity with students paying fees. But the foreign students coming to the university to study faced a problem. The local laws held that an individual could be held liable for the unpaid debts of a countryman. And so to manage this collective punishment quandary, the various nationalities formed together into mutual aid societies called nations, where the members could pool resources when one of its members owed a debt. Finding success with their collective actions, the nations took it another step further by joining with folks from other nations to spread the risk even further. These coalitions of nations were given the moniker Universitas, from the Latin meaning a whole or a corporation. The Universitas was democratically governed, with major decisions settled by majority vote. Additionally, they handled internal disputes and established welfare programs to support its members. It enjoyed considerable bargaining power with the city and eventually received civil and criminal jurisdiction over its members. This collective bargaining power translated to the students' relationships with their professors as well. Acting as an organized coalition, rather than paying individual fees to professors, the students could dictate class subjects, schedules, and professional salaries. Soon, the Universitas was hiring additional faculty compared to the previous freelance arrangements, and the University of Bologna was born, a university with society's needs at its foundation. And while universities have evolved into massive engines of knowledge, their potential for social upliftment is stronger than it's ever been. But that impact doesn't just happen on its own. And what is more, what does it look like? Allow me to reflect on this question by sharing an example from American history. In 1947, the civil rights leader Martin Luther King was an 18-year-old college student in a city called Atlanta. Already intensely focused on critical issues related to equality and justice, he wrote an essay in the campus newspaper titled, "The Purpose of Education." Dr. King argued that education solely focused on the pursuit of gaining intelligence is grossly incomplete. Instead, the goal of a true education is intelligence plus character. Dr. King concluded that complete education gives one not only the power of concentration, but worthy objectives upon which to concentrate. I see this character and worthy objectives in each of you. And by combining your character with worthy objectives, the result is the social upliftment that so typifies your university. Character and worthy objectives mean we look beyond ourselves. This is the true purpose of education. It can give us the knowledge, the tools, and the motivation to make a difference. At Cal Poly Pomona, we understand that talent is equally distributed across race, ethnicity, and gender, but that opportunity is not. And when you expand that opportunity, working to help as many as possible to succeed, you create something that can change entire communities, nations, and the world. So I have one humble request, and that is that you seek out worthy objectives that will allow you to leverage your education and knowledge to help others, to build communities, and to create positive change. Truly, your potential is limitless. You're carrying forth a legacy of empowerment through education that began almost a millennium ago. And fortunately, it's up to you to keep it going for just that much longer. Thank you again for inviting me to participate in today's ceremony. I offer you and all your family, friends, and loved ones my heartiest congratulations on this so truly deserved accomplishment. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Madam Kohli, for such a wonderful and inspiring message to the graduating class of 2020. Thank you for joining us online from California.
Now I would like to invite Pro Vice Chancellor, Ganpat University, Dr. Rakesh Patel, to deliver the vote of thanks. Please, sir.
Chief guest of today's event and President of California State University, Pomona, USA, Professor Saraya Kohli, President of Ganpat University, respected Ganpat Bhai Patel, Pro Chancellor and Director General of Ganpat University, Dr. Mahendra Sharma, Honorable Members of Board of Governors and Members of Academic Council, Invited Guests and Dignitaries, Executive Deans and Deans, Principal of Constituent Colleges, Office Bearers of the University, Faculty and Staff Members of the Ganpat University, Officials from Print Media and Visual Media, Respected Parents and My Dear Students. Yep. Presence has motivated and encouraged us, and I am here to express my gratitude for this favor. With every passing year, we are scaling newer heights. Ganpat University has emerged as an abode of excellence, and it has created its own unique identity, which is a matter of great pride for all of us. The student receiving the degrees will have the satisfaction that they are now qualified to undertake and accomplish very important tasks and responsibility in their life. I want to urge them all that play your part and pay back to society. Cherish the values we have inculcated in you and use the knowledge we have imparted in you in serving the mankind. You have been embarking upon an expedition and may succeed in whatever you do. Have a great life and great career ahead. In my concluding address, I honestly wish to thank everyone for their presence in making today's 14th convocation successful and memorable. At the outset, I thank Professor Saraya Kohli for honoring the invitation and for bestowing an inspiring convocation address. I, on behalf of the entire family of Ganpat University, express my deepest sense of gratitude to her. Our President Sri Ganpat Bhai Patel, whom we all address as Dada, is a pioneer and the man behind this noble mission. I thank you, Dada, for making yourself available virtually and for blessing our students. I want to thank Pro Chancellor and Director General Dr. Mahendra Sharma, sir, for his vision and leadership. He is a man of unique ideas and vital force for this university. Thank you, sir, for being with us and sharing your valuable thoughts with the gathering. Thank you to the members of Board of Governors and Academic Council
for their auspicious presence. Dr. Amit Patel, Pro Vice Chancellor and Executive Registrar of Ganpat University, deserves special thanks for planning and executing this mammoth task of Convocation Week. Thank you, Amit Bhai. Let me thank my colleagues, all the executive deans, deans, principal of constituent institutes, faculty member, section heads of the university, other staffs, and entire organizing committee who have strived very hard in organizing this nice event amidst so many adversities. I appreciate their efforts and thank them all for their valuable contributions. I congratulate and thank to recipients of scholastic medals and all their students for making us proud today. I thank all the parents who have been with us today. Thank to you all for your trust in us, and special thanks to media for being with us to cover this event. Finally, I thank everyone who has extended unshaken support in organizing this function. Thank you all. Jai Hind, Jai Jai Garve Gujarat.
Thank you very much, sir.
We request the president of Ganpat University, Dr. Ganpat I. Patel, to declare the closing of the convocation.
I declare the convocation closed.
Thank you, sir. We request all of you to rise at your place for the national anthem.
Dear students, it is the time for group photographs. To maintain the social distance and safety measures, we are going to announce a sequence for photograph. Dear students, we are going to invite you in two categories. First of all, PhD degree awardees are requested to come forward for the photograph. Kindly come on the stage from the side where you are sitting. Carry the degree file in your right hand for the photograph. All the PhD degree awardees are requested to move forward for the photograph. Kindly stand on the footmark placed on the stage. Maintain social distance. Maintain social distance. Photo, you are requested to get down in the same sequence and please go back at the back side of the sitting arrangement. Now, the gold medalist students. First of all, Wear the gold medal around your neck, hold the file in your right hand, and then come on the stage from the side where you are sitting. We'll move forward. Gold medalists from batch number G1 to G10, please come forward. G1 to G10. Hold the file in your right hand. G11, G20. Next group, G11 to G20. Next group, G21 to G30. Next group, G31 to G40. Next group, G41 to G50. Next group, G51 to G64. Stand on the footmark placed on the stage. Maintain social distance. G64 to G75. G64 to G75. Wear the gold medal first. Hold the file in the right hand. Hold the file in the right hand. Stand on the footmarks placed on the stage. Maintain social distance.
As inaugurated by the Pro Chancellor and Director General, Ganpat University has specially composed a wonderful track, We Are Gunwan, on this occasion of convocation. Please enjoy this foot-tapping Ganpat University convocation theme song.
Hope you may have a wonderful time.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, everyone, for your gracious presence. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, everyone.
हाथों में डिग्री है, दिलों में खुशियां हैं, आंखों में सपने हैं। We are the good ones, skillful and world class. आ गया वो दिन है, कुछ कर दिखाना है, कहीं ना थमना है, आगे ही बढ़ना है। We are the good ones, skillful and world class. We are the good ones, skillful and world class.
Skillful and world class.
We are the good ones, skillful and world class.
Have a wonderful time. Thank you.